Let's discuss about gravitational potential due to a hollow sphere. Say we are given with a hollow sphere of mass m and radius r. For this, we already discussed at the time of gravitational field strength that for outer region up to surface, the whole mass of this spherical shell can be assumed to be concentrated at its center C. As due to this mass, because of its symmetrical distribution in the surrounding, gravitational field exists in radially inward direction. So, we talk about an outer point P which is located at a distance x from center. We can simply state this shell behaves like a point mass located at its center. So, we can simply write at outer points where x is greater than r. Potential at point P or potential at outer point can be written as simply minus gm by x. That is the result of gravitational potential of a point mass at a distance x from the mass. Similarly, if we talk at surface points, for surface points x is equals to r, and on a surface if there is a point s, then v at point s can be written as minus gm by r. As for surface points also, we can consider whole mass is concentrated at the center. But if we talk about any interior point, say this is an interior point P which is located at a distance x, we know well that inside the shell gravitational field is zero. That means from surface to point P, gravitational field is zero. So whenever a mass is displaced from point S to inside P, no work will be done. As gravitational field is zero, no force is acting on it, so no work will be done in any displacement. So we can say potential difference at any interior point must be equal to potential at surface, or potential difference of any interior point with that of surface is always zero, because no gravitational field exists, so no work is done in displacement of a body within the interior region of a shell. So we can simply write at any interior point, we can write for x less than r, v inside is always equals to minus gm by r. That is a potential which is equal to that at the surface. So here we can also define one more parameter regarding the zone where g is 0. We can write down a note here that in a region, if at every point g is equals to 0, then this region can be taken as an equipotential region. Because if in any region g is 0, then there will never be any potential difference between two points of this region. So all points will be at same potential. As we already discussed, potential difference Vb minus Va between two points can be written as negative of g dot dx. In the previous section only we have studied is from A to B. So if g is 0 everywhere, that means the potential difference is 0, and this implies that all points are at equal potential, though this is also a very important factor to be understood and kept in mind. Let us discuss about variation of gravitational potential due to a hollow sphere. Like on previous slide, we have discussed that in a hollow spherical shell for x greater than r, we at outer points we write as minus gm by x. And for x equal to r, that is on surface point, potential is minus gm by r. And for x less than r, as everywhere g is 0, so inside the region is equipotential, so potential at all interior points we can write as minus gm by r only. It is same as that of the potential on surface. If we plot the graph of variation of potential with the distance x from center, we can write from 0 to r, that is inside zone, the potential remains constant at minus gm by r. So this is a horizontal straight line, and outside we can say it is inversely proportional to x. So finally we can say drops in magnitude, and here we can write potential is inversely proportional to x. The graph is plotted below the x region because everywhere the value of potential is negative.